Sucks. Growing up is totally optional, right?
Yes!
Going back to our first album back to 1981. Hard and heavy, a song we call Ooh Baby!
Thank you.
right now we're going to do some newer stuff. Start off with the title track from our last album, which was called Legal at Last, which is all about the legalization of marijuana. It's still quite a ways away, I know, here in Britain. But in Canada, we got a really fucking... really fucking fucked up Prime Minister. I think he smokes dope too. In fact, I know he does. Not that I've smoked one with him, but what the hell. But that's why I call him Prime Minister True Dope. Right? Here we go. Here's a song called Legal at Last. Something brand new, something from our newest album, Impact is Imminent. Okay. This one is all about my lifestyle, all about what I've done and where I've been and all the shit that I've gone through to get here, right? It's just a song we call Take a Lesson. A quick, easy question. Do you like rock and roll?
Yeah!
That doesn't sound that enthusiastic. You half-heartedly said that. I'm going to try it again. Do you love rock and roll?
Yeah!
Yeah, you're some badass rock and roll. We'll be right back. Right now we're going to go back in time a little ways. Not too far. You don't want to go into the ancient history or anything like that. Go back to 83 to our third album, not our turd album. From the Forged in Fire album, a song we call Winged Assassins.
Hey! 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 Hey!
in my fucking amp. Holy shit. All right. This next song I'd like to dedicate to the memory of the late, great Lemmy Kilmister. Come on, we know the history. You know that Anvil and Motorhead went right back to the early beginnings. And in fact, the first show we ever did as Anvil after we changed our name from Lips. We opened for Motorhead in Toronto. I could still remember watching Lemmy from side stage and watching us from side stage. Unbelievable, very nerve-wracking elbow, you know what I mean? I go up to him after the show, what'd you think, man? You guys are pretty fucking good, but you know what? You've got too many hard parts. I'm thinking, what's he talking about? Well, I don't think he was talking about that. He was talking about the music, but he had a lot of respect, and well, fuck, you know, about a year later, just after Iron Fist, they show up in Toronto to play a show, and, well, Fast Eddie Clark has a shit fit on fucking stage and leaves the band. The next thing I know, my phone is ringing. Hey, Lips, you want to join Motorhead? I'm in the middle of recording Forged in Fire. I don't think so. I have a lot of respect. I'd love to do it, but I won't do it because I'm dedicated to Anvil and my best friend, Rob Reiner. All right? And he said, yeah, cool. He was so respectful of that. In fact, in 83, later on that year, he invited us out to come here to the UK. It was our first fucking tour here. How awesome is that, man? Fuck. That's when I learned what No Sleep Till Hammersmith really meant. We get a night off, probably the only night off that I can remember, in Birmingham. So I go up to his hotel room, and he's sitting there with a 40-ounce bottle of fucking vodka and a 60-ounce bottle of orange juice, and he starts mixing it, and he goes, Lips, this is called vodka. Okay, I start drinking the vodka, and I got really, really fucking drunk quick, man, because basically, I'm a tea drinker, I'm not a booze drinker, but what the hell? When with Lemmy, you do that, right? So we start drinking, and I get pissed, and he looks at me and goes, Lips, you're looking a bit under the table. A bit? I'm fucking licking the goddamn floor. He goes, I've got just the solution. And he pulls this little black pouch out of his jean jacket and a pocket knife. He takes the pocket knife, dips it into the pouch, and out comes this white powder. He sticks the knife under my nose, and he goes, sniff it, you cunt. Okay. I'm thinking I'm doing a line of blow. Come on, we're talking about 1983. No, it's 100% fucking speed. Holy fuck, I'm just you just can't fucking sit still, man. It's like you got snakes running through your bloodstream. Holy shit. I suddenly realized, holy fuck, man, I'm doing drugs with Lemmy. This is unbelievable. Lemmy, you are one of the most influential people in metal. What an honor, man. Me square right in the eye, and he goes, Lips, in 6 fucking months, there'll be another bloke sitting across the table from you saying precisely the same thing. Fuck, that sounded good to me, man. Well, he wasn't wrong, man, because 6 months later, I found myself in Old Bridge, New Jersey, basically the home of the metal militia. Sounding familiar? Yeah, it was right at that fucking moment when Metallica came up from San Francisco and walked through the door into Metal Joe's house. Holy fuck. I, of course, who the fuck were Metallica? I had no idea. Of course, they were nobodies at that moment. They sit down at the kitchen table with me, and they're fucking freaking out. And Lars goes, man, do you know what it means to meet you, man? You're one of the most influential people in metal, man. I just looked them right in the eye, just like Lemmy showed me. In 6 months, they're going to be saying that to you, motherfucker. Hey, and you know what the moral of the story of this is? It's all about the music. little shy. You don't like to sing, do you? You know what? I'm going to tell you, and don't take this the wrong way, that's the first time we've done that and no one sang Wind. Pretty fucking wild, man. Are you out of the wind? Are you got no wind in your lungs? What the hell?
Let me hear you
go, Wind!
Wind!
There you go. All right. Right now we're going to... let's lift up this fucking... Let's lift up the feeling of the room right now. Let's start. Let's set this place on fire! Safe to say, you've all seen me fucking naked, right?
Yay!
Yeah, you should have seen the look on my wife's face. It took her to the premiere, right? She saw that, and I'm still getting over the rib shot. One of these. Okay. What the hell? You're naked. Yeah, I'm naked. But you know what? I haven't got anything no other guy has. You know what I mean? I've definitely got the same shit that's going on. We all got that same equipment, right, guys? You fucking know it.
Some of us are bigger than others, though.
Great memories, and I'm not talking about my dick, I'm talking about the song This Is 13.
Richie Blackmore part, man. Smoke on the water. I'm getting higher. I'm getting higher. I'm getting
higher.
I'm fucking
on the beautiful body of his guitar. Let's hear it for Lips!
Yeah! Right now we're going to do a song all about getting lost and then finding your way.
Yeah!
You know where I'm going with that, hopefully. Yeah. Bitch in the box! Right. Yeah. Sadly, things have gone over time. I crammed as much as I fucking could. We're gonna do the last song now. We had a fucking amazing time. I'm just as fucking ripped and torn as you are, man. I could play all fucking night, man. I gotta call it. This comes out to everybody, and I'm gonna come out and see and shake everybody's fucking hand at the end of this, alright?
Yeah!